We're speaking to national senior women's team player Mariah Shade on the night following the first friendly international against Venezuela. 0-0 draw, positive result. What do you felt about how things went today?
Yeah, I mean, I think we all were expecting a better performance from the team. We've been working really hard, and I was very excited for the game, and I know all the players were too. So it's a bit disappointing that we couldn't get the result we wanted today, which was to win, but a draw is not as bad as losing. So, you know, it's still something that we could keep our heads up and go into the next game a little confident.
How did you feel about the way the players were able to go out there and you know, handle the instructions passed on by Mariah and deliver at least at some of what she expected of you, what she wanted of the players?
Yeah, I think for the coach, once she sees us trying to implement what she's teaching us, even though we make mistakes, she would still be pleased about it. So I think the players, I mean, it could have been better, but we're trying. It's something new and different things that we do, like, for example, the throw-ins and the way we attack is different. So it's just about trying to implement it now as players.
In terms of the general setup here now, the team has been in camp, has been a lot of training sessions on a regular basis. How is this helping our women's football and your teammates as we look ahead to the qualifiers for France?
Well, it's very important to train every day and also to have the team together. That's a big issue that we have with the foreign players. So being in camp, it has been really good with training and everything. Hopefully the players that go back abroad could keep up their training, and we here could be consistent with our training also, that we could continue to improve. So when we come together, we could just be on one page.
What are your thoughts now? Obviously, you've worked with previous national team coaches in the past. You've worked with coaches abroad as well. What are your thoughts on the way Mariah and her staff, they've handled this team and their approach to the development of all football?
Yeah, well, they bring a level of professionalism to the team. I mean, we're just getting started, so I know there's a lot to learn and there's a lot for us to grow as a team, but this is just the second month, going into the second month, so we literally just started. So there's a lot, it's a long process ahead of us for 2019.
Just recently the FA has implemented something that is happening in women's football for the first time, maybe the first time for any form of national teams, both men and women, with the retainer contracts, and you're one of the players who are on the list. How do you feel about something like this, and what do you think this is going to do for players in terms of an additional incentive to give their all for the country?
Yeah, I believe it's something positive for us, because I've been playing with the national team since I was 13, and we've been working so hard and not really reaping any rewards, and I think that is something that we can be confident about, that we have security, because a lot of us, we don't have jobs, we have degrees, and we dedicate most of our life with football, so it's something that we can have to be confident about, that, you know, we could take care of business on the field, and then outside of the field we're also, you know, we have something to work with. So it's something good for the program and for the future of women's football.
All right, always a pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, okay.
We're here speaking with national senior team vice captain Arin King, national team defender for several years now, working under coach Karyn and Mariah. You played your first game today under the new coaching staff and new management. How you felt about things?
No, it's good to see, you know, where we are, to gauge, you know, where we are when we have to go. You know, we didn't have our best performance, you know, but it's, our chemistry's there, and, you know, we just need to bring it together for the next game.
How important are these two games at this stage of the preparations? Obviously, the tournament, the qualifiers are still a little bit way off, but now we can see the FA making an effort to get the team in game mode and in preparation mode at least some months in advance?
Yeah, it's huge. I mean, usually we'll get preparation games maybe a few weeks in advance, so a year and a bit more before is great for us, like I said, so we can gauge where we are and what we need to improve on and where we need to move forward. So it's huge that we have it before.
What's it like been for you? What's it been like for you and I guess your teammates as well, working under Mariah and trying to adapt to her or her demands and the way she wants to do things?
It's good. I mean, it's a change. She's very into details, which is great for us. But it's just trying to grasp what she's coaching and apply it to our style of play. So, yeah.
And how do you as a player feel about the effort, the emphasis on women's football development in the country right now?
It's huge because, as you know, if you don't start from the young age, you're trying to jump us into a high level and playing at the world stage without any foundation and background. So, you know, it's important in the women's game that we start from the grassroots and starting young, so implements like coaches' philosophy from young, so when they step into the senior team they already know what's expected and they can just ease their way in and transition smoothly.
as we look ahead to Wednesday's game now, an opportunity to get another proper practice game in, and what are your feelings in terms of maybe the team could at least maintain the sort of performance that you had today, maybe go a step better and get a better result?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, ground was hard for us. We really had to play firm passes, so it kind of slowed the game down a little bit. But I think we just need to work on our composure. We work very hard to get the ball back and just some easy giveaways. So I think if we just settle down, knock the ball around a bit, let the ball do the work, you know, we'll have better success.
And Arin, finally, the FA, for the first time in all of national teams football, has made an effort to sort of have the players a little bit secure and a little bit comfortable with the offering of the retainer contract. So how do you think, what sort of impact is this having on and an incentive for other players to want to get on that list as well?
Yeah, we made history with those retainer contracts, but it's just stability, because a lot of people don't know the women have it very, very hard. I mean, in the men's game, you know, they're getting pro contracts and they're having a foundation, a salary, stability. And for us women, it's sometimes we come to practice and, you know, we're coming on hungry bellies and stuff like that. So for the women, it's just great to have that kind of stability and moving forward, take the program to the next level with that.
Thanks a lot, Arin. Good luck. Good pleasure.
Learn what the coach has in store for us. The vibes, everything in camp has been great. It's just that, you know, we obviously working on a lot of things right now, and having to come in 5 days before to meet with the team, it's kind of tough for the coach to teach us everything. But at the end of the day, we have to learn as much as possible as we go along. But overall, I must say that it's a really good opportunity to be here and being in preparation as early as now, because in the past we had never really had that.
What would you say in terms of the actual spirit among the players now, and how have they adapted or responded to what Mariah is trying to get from the players?
I think really good, because at the end of the day, I never really seen our team cohesion that great. And I just like the vibes in the camp, and it's a really positive attitude, a positive energy. And I think that's what we're looking forward to. And I think that what make her happy to even come in and do her job, to be successful at the end of the day and help us move forward for preparation and to meet fans 2019.
And finally, another game against Venezuela on Wednesday, an opportunity for the players to show their worth and to show that, you know, preparations are on stream, and hopefully try to go a step further and maybe get a victory on Wednesday.
Yes, I think it's not beyond us, because we haven't played to our full potential today. And I think on Wednesday we will regroup, we will do the things that necessary that was missing in this game today, and then we move forward, and I think we should have a victory.
Karyn, thanks a lot. Good luck.